At least two or three books.
See, I always believed that architects should write. First two books were related with my tsunami work. One was based on a study. The other was on how to, I mean, the quality of construction is very important, how to improve the quality in construction, more like a construction manual. And the fourth book is, I've just written, completed one. I mean, it's in the final stages. It will be published in the next one. It's first coming in Malayalam, although I've written it in English. Then the English, it's for Laurie Baker for children. It covers his architectural principles in a simple way. We call this house pyramid because it was on a 40 feet by 40 feet with bamboo and thatched roof.
I saw solicitors.
And we have just kept the features. Only thing is we added, you see a skylight being added to the elevation. It's again like a double roof.
Okay.
The central portion is lifted.
Okay. Now the other distinguishing feature is the effective use of these Atangudi tiles.
See, the Atangudi tiles is the handmade tiles which is made in a village called Atangudi in Chettinad. One advantage is it comes in various colors and it's a tile which is not burned also. I mean, it's there is no firing is involved.
Oh, there's no firing involved.
There's no firing involved.
It's very beautiful, yeah. Very practical also. Ralph Strausser has been returning to spend his time in Chennai since almost the early 90s, to what it feels like to be in a space like this, which is so different from where you live in Boston.
Yeah, I love it. The kids love it. And a couple of reasons for that is it has an open feeling.
Yeah.
I like, in the mornings, I like sitting out here, and Anjali too, and the kids, we sit out here, have our tea, coffee. It's beautiful.
We are at the entrance to Dakshina Chitra, theme village started by the Madras Craft Foundation way back in 1996, which is an assemblage of models of several kind of traditional houses from South India at the moment.
That time, Benny was fresh from college and he was working with Laurie Baker. So for each of the states, we took a good 2 years to look at all the regions and the architecture in that region. And Baker allotted Benny to me as a young research student, wrote up all the notes meticulously and was very precise in everything he did, and I think that characterizes his work also. And I think with Benny, we covered the length and breadth of Kerala. We went into every Tharavad. We spent many nights in Tharavads. It was very exciting. How he found these houses, I don't know, because he would go on a back road and say, now you take a left on this dirt road and a right on that dirt road. And at the end of it, passing all the elephants bathing in the paddy fields, we'd see a wonderful house. Every time a house started to move, and then bringing it here and then seeing it come up, then I feel glorious. Laurie Baker did give designs for various buildings, but we found that some of them were not as practical as we needed given the climate next to the Bay of Bengal. I think that we made them very practical and within our budget. But Benny's been very good to work with. I don't think anyone understands, as I said, traditional materials as well as he does. And I think no one knows roofing structures as well as Benny. Every time I have a crisis, which is often, Benny has to come and solve it for me.
This is a house which is transplanted from Calicut. The first procedure is to detail and document the building in very detail.
How do you do that?
We make drawings and notes and each timber piece. For example, if there is a rafter from that side, 10th rafter, the 10th rafter will go exactly in the same way. Even on the smaller pieces we take it. So it's like a jigsaw puzzle. We dismantle the entire structure, bring it in a lorry,
yeah,
and then we bring it in as assembled here. That is the way it is.
So Benny, when you have to work at a site like this where, you know, several buildings exist, how do you conceptualize the idea of difference?
What I have tried to use in all these buildings is verandas is a major, very expressive element. Then the courtyards is also an expressive building. And if you look at this also, the roofs comes at different levels. If you like the buildings here, it comes at different level that depends on the span.
Since we are sitting under this lovely basic shelter of thatch and bamboo, you don't need an architect for it. My question to you is, had you not become an architect, was there something else that was playing in your mind that you wanted to become?
See, I was interested in photography, basically. I even had a black and white studio enlarger at home. After finishing my plus two at that time, when I passed out, Pune Film Institute used to take the plus two students. So I even got the application form and I just wanted to join for the cinematography course.
Okay.
Then my father was not very happy. His argument was that you take a basic degree,
then he wanted
and then he just said you can go to the same Pune Film Institute course or wherever mm-hmm. you want to go, you can go.
Cinema's loss has been architecture's gain.
I still might do it because now, I mean, I've worked with many cine field. I mean, I've done houses.
Oh, you have done houses for many film people.
Yeah, see, Mammootty's house I've done and Raju Menon's house I've done. Okay, so that way, okay. I mean, I'm doing one dance school for Shobana. So okay. like that, I'm still connected with many more others also.
Do you have a dream project in mind?
For me, I look forward, forward to all the projects, in fact. One of the projects which I enjoyed quite a bit is doing a palliative care center where the care is free and, where the people who are going to spend their last few days in their life will get admitted. So we had a meeting with the doctors and nurses and volunteers. We asked them, what kind of hospital or what is the you like the best? Then everybody said, I'm in a hospital which looks like a home. Then we said, we'll try to create a place which doesn't look like a hospital but more like a home. When I visited the first place and I asked one of the patients, how do you feel? He doesn't know that I'm the architect. He said, when I come to this place, half my illness is gone. And that is what one has to do in design.
So Benny, we have had a extremely productive day traveling through different parts of the city, seeing all the various kind of architectural explorations and journeys that you've made. For me, it seems like, if I were to use a stronger term, a critique of what is generally being practiced.
I'm not sure whether this is a critique or anything. I've not thought on anything on those lines. That is one thing. Of course, if I am asked to do a IT building or something like that, I will never be doing it with glass and the way it is normally done now.
There's also something called the wisdom of the past.
It's the wisdom of the past. I can't throw those things. And I think the relevance of these kind of projects, these kind of things will become more and more evident in the years to come.
So thank you very much for sharing your thought, your life, your work with us. And I'm very sure that the viewers are going to take a lot away home from what you've said. Thank you so much.
Thank you.